The Big Brother billionaires presented themselves once again to the U.S. Senate like knee-knocking fifth graders who had been called to the principal's office. Twitter's Jack Dorsey, Facebook's Mark Zuckerberg, and Google's Sundar Pichai defended their policies that protect the free speech of dictators while censoring the President of the United States no less than 65 times.
I have a tweet here from Mr. Ajit Pai. He recounts some four tweets by the Iranian dictator, Ayatollah Ali Khamenei, which Twitter did not place a public label on. They all four of them glorify violence.
Well, we believe it's important for everyone to hear from global leaders. And we have policies around world leaders. We want to make sure that we are respecting their right to speak and to publish what they need. We did not find those to violate our terms of service because we considered them saber-rattling.
Mr. Dorsey, you all have censored Joe Biden zero times. You have censored Donald Trump 65 times. So let me ask you this. Who elected the Ayatollah?
I don't know.
You don't know? Okay. I think this is called a dictatorship. So are people in Iran allowed to use Twitter, or does the country whose leader you claim deserves a platform ban them from doing so?
Ideally, we would love for the people of Iran to use Twitter.
Yeah. Well, Iran bans Twitter, and Mr. Zuckerberg, I know you are aware, they ban Facebook also. So, Mr. Dorsey, is Donald Trump a world leader?
Yes.
Okay. So it would be important for world leaders to have access to your platform, correct?
Correct.
And so why do you deny that platform via censorship to the U.S. president?
We haven't censored the U.S. president.
Oh, yes, you have. So given your refusal to censor or ban foreign dictators while regularly censoring the president, aren't you at this very moment personally responsible for flooding the nation with foreign disinformation?
Just to be clear, we have not censored the president.
As expected, the Democrats tossed the future of free speech into the garbage for their mountain of campaign donations from Silicon Valley, poisoning the well on the expectations of millions of Americans who have had enough.
Frankly, I am appalled that my Republican colleagues, they seem to want to bully and browbeat the platforms here.
To our witnesses today, you and other tech leaders need to stand up to this immoral behavior. The truth is that because some of my colleagues accuse you, your companies, and your employees of being biased or liberal, you have institutionally bent over backwards and overcompensated.
I have to be honest, it makes my blood boil, and it also breaks my heart a little as I watch my Republican colleagues just days before an election sink down to the level of Donald Trump.
We all know the corporocratic Congress will continue its Hegelian dialectic political theater while Silicon Valley stomps the communist foothold into the United States.
So yes or no, I would ask this of each of the three of you. Are the Democrats correct that you all are the legitimate referees over our political speech? Mr. Zuckerberg, are you the ref?
Senator, I certainly think not, and I do not want us to have that role.
Mr. Dorsey, are you the ref?
No.
Mr. Pichai, are you the ref?
We really believe and support maximizing freedom of expression.
I'll take that as three no's, and I agree with that. You are not the referees of our political speech.
2 weeks ago, Twitter and to a lesser extent Facebook crossed a threshold that is fundamental in our country. 2 weeks ago, Twitter made the unilateral decision to censor the New York Post in a series of two blockbuster articles, both alleging evidence of corruption against Joe Biden, the first concerning Ukraine, the second concerning communist China. And Twitter made the decision, number one, to prevent users, any user, from sharing those stories. And number two, you went even further and blocked the New York Post from sharing on Twitter its own reporting. Why did Twitter make the decision to censor the New York Post?
We had a hack materials policy.
When was that policy adopted?
In 2018, I believe.
In 2018, go ahead. What was the policy?
So the policy is around limiting the spread of materials that are hacked. We didn't want Twitter to be a distributor for hacked materials. We found that the New York Post, because it showed the direct materials, screenshots of the direct materials, and it was unclear how those were attained, that it fell under this policy. Now,
so in your view, if it's unclear the source of a document, and in this instance, the New York Post documented what it said the source was, which it said it was a laptop owned by Hunter Biden that had been turned into a repair store. So they weren't hiding what they claimed to be the source. Is it your position that Twitter, when you can't tell the source, blocks press stories?
No, not at all. Our team made a fast decision. The enforcement action, however, of blocking URLs, both in tweets and in DM, in direct messages, we believe was incorrect. And we changed it.
Today, right now, the New York Post is still blocked from tweeting 2 weeks later.
Yes, they have to log into their account, which they can do at this minute, delete the original tweet, which fell under our original enforcement actions, and they can tweet the exact same material from the exact same article, and it would go through.
So, Mr. Dorsey, your ability is you have the power to force a media outlet. Let's be clear. The New York Post isn't just some random guy tweeting. The New York Post has the fourth highest circulation of any newspaper in America. The New York Post is over 200 years old. The New York Post was founded by Alexander Hamilton. And your position is that you can sit in Silicon Valley and demand of the media that you can tell them what stories they can publish, and you can tell the American people what reporting they can hear. Is that right?
No. This was every person, every account, every organization that signs up to Twitter agrees to a terms of service.
Mr. Dorsey, who the hell elected you and put you in charge of what the media are allowed to report and what the American people are allowed to hear? And why do you persist in behaving as a Democratic super PAC, silencing views to the contrary of your political beliefs?
We're not doing that.
Can you name for me one high-profile person or entity from a liberal ideology who you have censored and what particular action you took?
Senator, I can get you a list of some more of this.
I just want one name of one person or one entity.
Senator, I need to think about it and get you more of a list.
Can you identify any example?
Yes, but two Democratic Congress people on election.
What are their names?
I'll get those names too.
We have had compliance issues with World Socialist Review, which is a left-leaning publication.
At least with respect to Mr. Zuckerberg and Mr. Dorsey, and I would point out that with respect to Mr. Pakai, those are not nearly as high profile. I don't know if I can identify anyone picked at random from the public, even picked at random from the public as far as members of the political active community in either political party who could identify those right off the top of the bat.
Let's face it, you all believe that Russia has the ability to influence elections or interfere by using your social platforms. Mr. Dorsey, do you still deny that you don't have the ability to influence and interfere in our elections?
My answer was around people's choice around other communication channels.
No, your answer was, the question was, does Twitter have the ability to influence elections? You said no. Do you still stand by that answer?
Twitter as a company, no. No,
you don't think you have the ability by moderation policies, by as Senator Lee would call, and I would call it censoring, what you do with the New York Post. You don't think that censorship, that moderation of policies, you don't think that influences elections by withholding what I believe is true information from the American public? You don't think that interferes in elections?
Not our current moderation policies. Our current moderation policies are to protect the conversation and the integrity of the conversation around the elections.
Mr. Zuckerberg?
Senator, as I testified before, we relied heavily on the FBI's intelligence and alerts to us, both through their public testimony and private briefings and alerts they gave us.
Did the FBI contact you and say the New York Post story was false?
Senator, not about that story specifically.
Let me give you a tweet that was put up on Twitter. It says, Senator Ron Johnson is my neighbor and strangled our dog, Buttons, right in front of my 4-year-old son and 3-year-old daughter. The police refused to investigate. This is a complete lie, but important to retweet and note that there are more of my lies to come. Now, we contacted Twitter, and we asked him to take it down, and here's the response. Thanks for reaching out. We escalated this to our support team for their review, and they have determined that this is not a violation of our policies. That tweet was retweeted like something like 17,000 times and viewed by over and loved, commented, you know, appreciated by over 50,000 people. How is that not voter suppression? How is that not election interference? How does that not affect the civic integrity?
Well, we'll have to look into our enforcement or non-enforcement in this case of the tweet, and we can get back to you with more context.
The only possible hope America has is to re-elect Donald Trump. John Bowne reporting.